This is the one I decided on. I really liked the size of it. I love the curves. I like the little legs. And so all I needed to do was get the 2x4 that had been used to raise it up. I'm sure you've heard me say before that Miss Mustard Seed Milk Paint is one of my most favorite paints. So I decided to use French Enamel and Flow Blue. I think they're going to match the colors in my house really nicely. Mixing milk paint is really easy, so don't let it intimidate you. It is simply one part powder to one part water. Using hot water helps, but it's not required. So after I mixed it up, I just let it sit for a few minutes. Now I am going to use the new Zebra brushes that we've gotten. I really do like the consistency here, and normally I use the Klingon, but I do want to give these Zebras a shot. They are really nice brushes. They are super soft and they do a great job of holding a lot of paint despite their size. And I'm going to use them in sort of a blending effect. This is going to be a very basic blend. Really, it's barely a blend. It's just sort of a mash together of the two colors so that they feed into one another. As with most paints, you'll want to apply two good coats of Miss Mustard Seed Milk Paint. And you can see the color is really luscious and it's got a good consistency. The thicker your coats, the more likely you are to have chipping and cracking. A heat gun is also a great tool to force cracks and chips. For this piece, I'm using Dixie Belle's Royal Damask stencil. It has a really nice thickness, and the key to getting a beautiful sort of stencil that looks timeless and worn and not freshly painted is to use a good soft stencil brush and then put minimal paint on your brush, getting most of it off, and then going in a swirling pattern, making sure that you're coating heavier in some areas than in others. And one of my favorite things about the stencil is it's actually repeating, so all you have to do is line it up and stencil the next section. Now that I've finished the stenciling, it is time to go in and do a little bit of the distressing. This is where I am going to take any pieces that are super chippy and go ahead and knock them off. This is not about high pressure distressing, this is just about taking what's loose and getting it off the piece and softening up the harsher lines of my stencil. I want this piece to look really old. I don't want it to look freshly painted. I want it to look like it's been sitting around for years. And you can seal over milk paint with either using a hemp oil, a wax, or a top coat. And I opted to go for a top coat. With this Hokus Pokus transfer, I actually had three beautiful sheets to choose from. I chose this one primarily because it had the writing over where the biggest chips were. Just like IOD and Prima transfers, all you need to do is use the enclosed stick to rub the transfer down onto your piece. And no matter how many times you do this, the reveal is always exciting to see. I'm going to use a pilot screw to make the first screws from the front, and then I'm going to use a slightly larger bit in order to expand that so that the screw that'll actually hold the piece in will go up. And the first pilot hole is always from the front. That way, if there's any major chip out, it's on the back side where you won't see it. And here I'm just adding some wooden French cleats, much sturdier than using D-rings. Now I finally get to add all of my little knobs, and this is where I should be done, except for it seems like I'm never really done with a project. I was still feeling like it was missing just a little something. I decided everything was still looking way too clean for me, and so it was time to go in and start adding some waxes. I started off with Dixie Belle's Best Dang Wax in the color white. Really any white wax would do, but this is what I had open and on hand. What I love about this is it gets into all the little nooks and crannies so that you can really see all of the cracking. Next, I'll go in with some Easy Peasy Spray Wax. I love this stuff. It makes waxing with the dirt and the dusts so easy. And then I'm going in with some Dixie Dirt and the color Ash. And I'm just gonna make this a little bit grungy. And again, I don't like the new look, so I'm gonna make sure it looks old, 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 getting it into all the nooks and crannies. Hopefully you can see in these up close views that the combination of the white wax and the dust really creates a beautiful effect of having it age over time, and keeping that vintage chippiness in really added a lot of dimension and texture.